This evening, the Majaka, ladies and gentlemen, His Excellency, but also an honor, deputies, accompany. We proceed to the medical outreach behind the cenotaph. After that, he moved to sign the register.
His Excellency is signing the register for the memorable occasions. He has just finished signing the book of. I want to exchange this present dignity under the grand open. From there, he moved back to the saluting diet for a national salute.
His Excellency is exchanging pleasantries with members of the High Table dignitaries under the canopy. His Excellency, the Deputy Governor of Kogi State, Chief Edward David Onocha, the State APC Chairman, the Secretary to the State Government, the Chief of Staff, among others, honorable commissioners are there. His Excellency is standing presently with the Royal Fathers, their Royal Majesties and Royal Highnesses that create this program. After exchange of pleasantries, His Excellency will go to the saluting desk. Bye, if I need to say. Thank you. His Excellency is in exchange presentries with dignitaries that have come to grace the ceremony today. The 2021 Armed Forces Remembrance Day is up. His Excellency move back to the saluting diet, awaiting the national salute, accompanied by various commanders of the security agencies. Commander is now marching smartly to take permission from the governor to march off the colors and the rest of the parade.
May I have your permission to march off the colors and the rest of the parade, Your Excellency?
As the color passes off, may I, with due respect, humbly request all to please rise while officers and warrant officers in uniform are to salute. Senior officers, distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, with this we have come to the end of the year 2021 Forces and Remembrance Day celebration in Kogi State, precisely. Thank you all for coming and I wish you a safe journey back to your various destinations.
No, just see where you are. The heightened security issues in Nigeria. Would you subscribe to the idea of having some of our ex-servicemen who are still capable and willing to provide some sort of security advice, or you know, to still go to the battlefield in a way?
Thank you very much. Let me first use this opportunity to thank God for those of us that are alive today, and for servicemen that are alive today, serving us and continue to sacrifice the unity and togetherness of this country. Today we are gathered to remember our fallen heroes, those who have come to serve and pay the supreme sacrifice, so that those of us as a people and as a nation can live together in peace, secured, and in unity. To your question, I think the Nigerian Armed Forces, as we have it today, there are those that are serving today or retired, but they're never tired. You can see, for instance, my state security advisor, he's retired, but never tired, and is giving his best in the service of this country and of this state. So I will recommend that those that are still very vibrant and they have ideas and experiences to share in securing this country should be engaged, so that we can have a viral and secured environment. Let me use this opportunity to appreciate Mr. President and all the service chiefs for the wonderful job they are doing in securing this country from northeast to northwest to north central, southeast, southwest to south south, all across the country, in defending the territorial integrity of this country and securing or maintaining the internal peace and security of this country. May God continue to strengthen them and give them the wisdom in ensuring that this country is secured and stay together in unity. And I urge my fellow politicians, my brothers and sisters, to continue to cooperate and show understanding for Mr. President and all the service chiefs. All the service chiefs, including the Inspector General of Police, they are trying their best. Considering what was inherited by this administration, where bombs were being detonated every day in the northeast, even down to the FCT. Today, we're no longer facing that same circumstance or situation. It is a credit to Mr. President. It is a credit to all the service chiefs. It is a credit to Nigerian people who are up to defend and volunteer credible information so that the security forces will do their best. I equally urge the federal government to up their game in ensuring that the welfare and well-being of our servicemen and those of our fallen heroes, their family members, are quickly and enhanced, so that they can continue to give their best to the service of this country. Let me use this opportunity once again to call on, to appreciate Kogi citizens who have continually showed their support, cooperation, and understanding to us and we as a government and as a people. The security and peace we are enjoying today in Kogi State wouldn't have been possible without your cooperation. You are cooperating with us as a government, you are cooperating with our service chiefs and our security agencies across the state. That is why Kogi State still remains the most peaceful state and secure state across the country. Because of your cooperation and security and safety that we are enjoying in Kogi State, you could see that last year we have the highest foreign direct investment in Kogi State. We beat Lagos, we beat all other bigger states. We will continue to do our best to ensure that the state is secured and safe, so that more investment, more jobs, more infrastructure will come to our state. I will use this opportunity once again to warn the remnants of any other criminal from anywhere across the length and breadth of Kogi State to take a flight immediately. 2021 is going to be tougher for criminals in Kogi State. I can swear that wherever you are, we are going to get at you. We have come up with modern technology. We have come up with modern way of getting you from wherever you are. You are living amongst us. You are coming from far and near to come and commit crime in Kogi State. We will root you out. There will be no mess for criminals in Kogi State. Whether you are resident, whether you are indigent, whether you are passerby, or whether you are a visitor, Kogi State is going to be free. Kogi State is going to be safer than ever before. I salute all of you, and I wish you a happy new year once again. Thank you, sir.
Your Excellency, sir. Happy